Learning with Dr. Shivangi. Today's topic is goodness of measurement scale. So what type of test for checking the goodness of measurement scale we will discuss in this video about that topic. Before starting the video, I want to say you that if you like my video, please like and share this video, subscribe my channel, which is Learning with Dr. Shivangi. Now coming to the main topic, goodness of measurement of a scale or test of sound measurement of scales. Basically, measurement scale has to have certain desirable qualities to judge their goodness in measuring the characteristics under study. There are four types of test to test the goodness of measurement, which is validity, reliability, practicality, and accuracy, by which we can check the goodness of measurement scale, the scales which are using in the research process. Now coming to the main topic, first topic, which is validity. What is test of validity? Validity refers to the extent to which a test measures what we actually wish to measure. Validity is the most critical criteria and indicates the degree to which an instrument measures what it is supposed to measure. Validity can also be thought of as utility. In other words, validity is the extent to which differences found with a measuring instrument reflect true differences among those being tested. So validity is most important term or concept to check the scaling technique. But the question arises, how can one determine validity without direct confirming knowledge? The answer may be that we seek other relevant evidence that confirms the answers we have found with other measuring tools. What is relevant evidence often depends upon the nature of the research problem and the judgment of the researcher. But one can certainly consider three types of validity in this connection: content validity, criterion related validity, and construct validity. All these three validity we will discuss in the next videos also. If the above stated criteria and tests are met with, we may state that our measuring instrument is valid and will result in correct measurement. Otherwise, we shall have to look for more information and or resort to exercise the judgment. There are so many methods which we are using to check the validity according to purpose of the research process. In few processes, there is content validity used, in the few construct validity used, and in the few criterion related validity is used. Not all types of validity is used in all research processes. So we have to check the validity of the questionnaires or the instruments which we are using in the research process. The next term or next test is test of reliability. Reliability with the accuracy and precision of the measuring procedure. The test of reliability is another important test of sound measurement. A measuring instrument is reliable if it provides consistent result. Reliable measuring instruments does contribute to validity, but a reliable instrument need to be valid instrument. As in the case of validity, we can check validity through correlation between the variables or the instrument which we are using in the research process. But there is a different method for reliability check, which is Cronbach alpha method, by we can check the reliability of the instruments or the variables which we are using in the research process. So it is also a very important parameter to check the goodness of the measurement tool or scales. For instance, a scale that consistently overweighs object by 5 kgs is a reliable scale, but it does not give a valid measurement of weight. But the other way is not true, that is, a valid instrument is always reliable. Accordingly, reliability is not as valuable as validity, but it is easier to assess reliability in comparison to validity. If the quality of reliability is satisfied by an instrument, then while using it can be confident that the transient and situational factors are not interfering. So a valid instrument is not always reliable, and it is easier to assess reliability in comparison to validity. This is a particular method, Cronbach alpha, I already mentioned in the video. And the validity can be checked also through correlation method. And there are so many methods others also for check the validity of the instruments. Two aspects of reliability, that is stability and equivalence, deserves special mention. The stability aspect is concerned with the securing consistent results with repeated measurements of the same person with the same instruments. We usually determine the degree of stability by comparing the results of repeated instruments or measurements. The equivalence aspect considers how much error may get introduced by different investigators or different samples of the items being studied. So there are two aspects of reliability, stability and equivalence parameter aspects. Both have different purpose and different measurement criteria. A good way to test the equivalence of measurements by two investigators is to compare their observations of the same events. Reliability can be improved in the following two ways: by standardizing the conditions under which measurement takes place. That is, we must ensure that external sources of variation such as boredom, fatigue, etc. are minimized to the extent possible. That will improve stability aspects. By carefully designed directions for measurement with no variation from group to group, by using trained and motivated persons to conduct the research, and also by broadening the sample of items used, this will improve equivalence aspect. Now we coming to the next point, which is test of practicality. Practicality is concerned with the wide range of factors of economy, convenience and interpretability. The practicality characteristic of measuring instrument can be judged in terms of economy, convenience and interpretability. From the operational point of view, the measuring instrument ought to be practical. It should be economical, convenient and interpretable. Economic considerations suggest that some trade-off is needed between ideal research project and that which the budget can afford. So these are the parameters or factors which affect the practicality of the research process or research instrument, which is economy, convenience and interpretability. The length of measuring instrument is an important area where economic pressure are quickly felt, although more items give greater reliability as stated earlier. But in the interest of limiting the interview or observation time, we have to take only few items for our study purpose. Similarly, data collection methods to be used are also dependent at times upon economic factors. Convenience tests suggest that the measuring instrument should be easy to administer. So these are the tests which we are using in the practicality test of the research instrument and research process. For this purpose, one should give due attention to the proper layout of the measuring instrument. For instance, a questionnaire with clear instructions is certainly more effective and easier to complete than one which lacks these features. Interpretability consideration is especially important when persons other than designers of test are to interpret the results. The measuring instrument, in order to be interpretable, must be supplemented by detailed instructions for administrating the test, scoring keys, evidence about the reliability, and guides for using the test for interpreting the results. So these are the factors for interpretability of the research instrument. Now coming to the fourth and last point, which is accuracy. The characteristics of accuracy of measurement scale means it should be a true representative of the observation of underlying characteristics. For example, measuring with an inch scale with scale which provide accurate value only up to 1/8 of inch, an inch, while measuring with cm scale, centimeter scale will provide more accurate value. So this is the accuracy of the parameters or numbers in any research instrument and research process. So this is all about the test of goodness of measurement scales and test of sound measurement of scales. I again summarize all the points so that you can easily understand about the topic. So these are the four parameters which we have to test for sound measurement of scales, which are validity, reliability, practicality and accuracy. In the case of validity, we have to check the validity in terms of what we have to get and what we have to measure. Validity are of three types: criterion validity, construct validity and content validity. There is an easier method of validity check is correlation method, but there are so many methods also to check the validity, which we are discussing in the next videos also. So it is also a very important parameter to check the soundness of the measurement tool and search instruments. In the case of reliability, we have to check the accuracy and precision of the measurement procedure. Reliability can be checked through Kronberg alpha method, which we are discuss which we'll discuss in the next videos also about the Kronberg alpha method, how to check the reliability through this method. There are so many parameters also in the reliability. Two aspects of reliability are also used, for example, stability and equivalence method. Equivalence aspect of reliability, we have to use this aspect according to our purpose of research process and measurement tools also. Next point is practicality. There are three parameters of practicality, which is economy, convenience and interpretability. In the economy, we have to check the budget of the research process. In the convenience, we have to check the measuring instrument to be easier or not. And in the interpretability, we have to check it is interpretable or not by the three parameters, which is detailed instructions, administering the test and scoring keys, evidence about the reliability, and last is guides for using the test and interpreting the results. Next point is accuracy, which is the last parameter to test the goodness of measurement scaling, which is accuracy. Accuracy is check in terms of quantitative methods, quantitative values. For example, inches and centimeters. Centimeters is more accurate than inches parameters, inches scales. So this is all about the test of sound measurement or sound good measurement scales. If you want to know about this video, this topic or any the topic related to research methodology, you can ask me through comment box. If you like my video, please like and share this video and subscribe my channel, which is Learning with Dr. Shivangi. We will meet in the next video with new topic. Thank you, everyone.